Now that we've seen a comparison of analog and digital meters, let's concentrate on analog meters and how they work. When we talk about meter movements, we refer only to analog meters, since digital meters do not move. Let's see some differences between these analog meters. This meter is a simple, single-scale, single-range ammeter. Single-scale indicates that only one scale or set of values is shown on the face of the meter. With a single-scale meter, there is only one value that the needle or pointer can be pointing to. On this multi-scale meter, notice that two scales are shown on the face of the meter. A switch selects between the scales. Single function means that it is only used to measure one quantity, in this case, amps. Other meters, such as this one, are multifunction. They can measure more than one quantity. This electronic multimeter can measure volts, ohms, or amps. We call this meter single range because it can measure only within a fixed, non-changeable range as shown on the scale, 0 to 10 amps. This meter is multi-range. A range switch changes the value the meter can indicate. No matter what type of analog meter you use, the basic mechanism is the meter movement. The most common type of meter movement is the permanent magnet moving coil movement, which is generally called the d'Arsonval movement after its inventor, Arsène d'Arsonval. Within the movement, a stationary magnetic field is created by a horseshoe magnet with a soft iron core placed between the poles. The moving coil fits between the poles and the core with enough space to rotate freely. The meter pointer is attached to the moving coil so that it moves as the coil moves. Counterweights are often attached to the pointer to create a perfect balance for more accurate readings. Retaining pins at both ends of the movement prevent the pointer and other rotating parts from moving too far in either direction. Now let's look at what happens when current flows through the coil. Flux lines flow from north to south in the permanent magnetic field. From the previous lesson on electromagnetism, recall that an electromagnetic field will interact with a permanent magnetic field. As current flow increases and the coil's flux lines expand, they cause the coil and its attached pointer to deflect proportionally farther. When current stops flowing, a spring in the movement pushes the pointer back to its resting place.